members of the graduating class, parents, teachers, administrators, friends, we are a great and free society. Some of us believe in God, some of us don't. Some of us like to pray, and some of us don't. But this prayer is done in the conviction that when the great events of life happen, like your graduation, there are Christians who gather to pray, and that those who don't want to are gathered also to respect those who pray. In that spirit, let us pray. You have come into the world that we may have life and have it abundantly, and we thank you for this tremendous life, O Lord, that's gathered before us. We are free to acknowledge you or free to rebel, free to acknowledge a life of obedience or rebel, free to acknowledge your authorities or free to rebel. For the gift of freedom, O God, we thank you. For the gift of life, we thank you. For the gift of parents and teachers and schools, we thank you. But especially we thank you for these magnificent young lives, and we ask you to bless them and their families this night. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.
At this time, I would call Kari Harstead to welcome all of you. Kari is the Vice President of the Class of 1986.
Class of 1986 would like to welcome you to the 28th commencement at Fridley High School. We are truly glad to see so many people here tonight to share in this turning point in our lives. For it is the end of our high school years, but more importantly, it is the beginning of our adult life. Again, welcome and thank you for coming. Thank you.
Come on, we gotta graduate here. Let's go. First of all, they didn't tell me that I'd be using two microphones, so I'm trying to adjust here. Okay, I got a speech written. First of all, it starts with very appropriate greetings. Well, we finally made it. We've waited a long time for this day, and it's finally here. And before we know it, it will be over. I found out that I was chosen to give this speech in October. That gave me about 6 months to write this speech, right? Wrong. Being a typical senior, I waited to the last possible moment to write it. When I finally sat down to think of what to write, I had no idea of what to say, because I'm not really experienced at giving commencement speeches. But one day in SSR, I started writing and everything fell into place. I know you're wondering what I was doing writing in SSR. Okay, I abused it. It seemed like a nice time to do it, except of course when the announcements came on, everybody started to talk and I lost all concentration. To begin, I want to go back to the first day of kindergarten. You always hear about how people go to the back of the bus and stick their faces against the window and plead their moms not to make them go. I was wondering, whatever happened to those of us who walked? Did we pretend we were on a bus and walk backwards and cry, or what? Somehow that piece of information gets left out of history. Well, anyway, we all made it to school, and we seemed pretty energetic. We knew what we were, well, kindergarten flew by fast, and we knew it. Okay, I'm just a little bit nervous. Kindergarten flew by fast, and before we knew it, we were learning how to eat the school lunch. We learned how to pick up a tray, a milk, and of course, silverware. After trying the food, we immediately made Mom and Dad go out and get us lunch boxes. Some of us got Emergency, some got Starsky and Hutch, and even some got Charlie's Angels. Whatever the kind, we treasured it and were very proud of it. When it came time in first grade for the real thing, we were ready. This experience would later help us when the lunch format at the high school was changed, and we had to use our expertise to figure out the difference between the a la carte line and the lunch line. See, first grade taught us something. But lunch wasn't the only thing that first grade had to it. We had problems controlling our bladders. We had a puppy love toward our teachers, and unbelievably so, we were very exciting and energetic. Then came second grade. This was the year of girl germs and boy germs, of picking our noses, and of such nicknames as Four Eyes, Dork, and Dude. In third grade, we learned what the word practical joke meant. We pulled every trick in the book, from putting a tack on the teacher's chair to putting a frog in her drawer. You name it, we either probably did it or either at least attempted it. It wasn't a fun year for the teacher. In fourth grade, we took each other to court for such things as running down the hill, calling each other names, and overdue library books. Mrs. Georges would like that one. This was also the last year of six elementary schools. We found out that three schools were going to close. The Gardena kids were shipped to Rice Creek, the Riverwood kids were shipped to Stevenson, and the Parkview kids were shipped to Hayes. Before we knew it, instead of one class that included all of us, we had three different classes with people we didn't even know. Yet we adjusted. In fifth grade, we spent most of our time playing in chess and checker tournaments and preparing for the big track meet held every spring. Being a Rice Creeker, our goal was to beat the Hayes team. As usual, Hayes won. Fifth grade was also a time to get ready to rule the school. Then came the time we had all waited for during elementary school. It was our turn to be the sixth graders. We walked around acting tough, noses in the air, studly walks, just thinking we ruled. We did this until somebody told us that we had to get ready for the junior high. Excuse me, middle school. Then came the rumors. Some said that everybody got initiated. The ways varied and all were horrid thoughts. There were such rumors as they made you run around the track with peanut butter under your armpits and eat it, or they threw you in Moore Lake. Whatever the rumor, junior high sounded like a nightmare. Well, we made it to junior high, and amazingly enough, the rumors weren't true. However, quite a few of us ended up with bumps on our lockers, bumps on our heads after getting hit into the lockers. But bumps weren't the only things we gained. We gained new friends. That's right, most of us have a new friend. Some still do today. Seventh grade was a time for growing in more ways than one. In eighth grade, we started forming groups of friends, better known as cliques, These cliques lasted through junior high and into high school. We also spent time preparing, once again, to rule the school. Eighth grade was also a time for fighting. A fight broke out almost every week. This, at least, would keep us entertained. Once again, it was time for us to rule the school. It was our turn to biff people into lockers, initiate, and basically do anything we wanted, because we were the ninth graders. Little did we know, a year later, how different things would be, for we were crossing the street to the senior high. The junior high had its moments, though. There was the ninth grade science project, geography, band, choir, the plays, the sports, and who could forget, the couples. Guys would ask girls to go with them, and this was the dating system. Conforming was in, and our individual selves took a back seat until senior high, when we realized how special each of us really was. All in all, junior high held some good memories for everyone. Now came the big jump. The senior high awaited us. Again, rumors of initiation spread. This time, however, some of them came true. All in fun, of course. Most of the people either got taken out to breakfast at 5 a.m. or got thrown into our beautiful lake out front, the infamous Moore Lake. But 10th grade was a time for learning. Not all was educational, however. We learned what senior high was all about. We went to dances, to parties, to movies, bowling, and of course, down Fast Food Alley. To aid in these adventures, we got our driver's licenses. With this came the driving stories. We experienced our first flat tire, our first stall in the middle of an intersection, and our first accidents. For me, it was backing into a brand new car going 20 miles an hour. For others, it was flipping the car after falling asleep, getting rear-ended, or just plain hitting a stop sign. Some of us experienced the agony of telling our parents, but of course, in time, they forgave us. Still others received various kinds of tickets. Some got tickets for going 55 and a 30, others got some for running stop signs, and some even got busted by none other than the school patrol. In 11th grade, we spent time preparing to take over the school. We watched and waited. By this time, most of us had part-time jobs, some at fast food places, some at offices, and even some as DJs. No, not Don Johnson's, disc jockeys. We spent the night cruising, working, and doing homework. It seemed like we were on no-dos every day. Yet we survived. We had to, for we wanted to graduate. But before the year was over, actually after the year was over, we experienced what Fridley fans had waited for. We had a team in a state tournament. Our baseball team went to state, and the city went crazy. We helped set an attendance record, and with their second place, we were on our way to an exciting summer, one that would pass very quickly. Before we knew it, we were seniors. We suddenly realized that this was our last year to do everything. It was our last year for homecoming, Sadie Hawkins, our last football game, our last play performance, and of course, our last tennis meet. We enjoyed these events to the utmost of their ability, and we went out of our way to have fun. Fun. That was the main word for the senior year. We counted down the days, and the time has finally come. We've had a lot of fun the last 12 years. As kids, we've listened to such songs as We Will Rock You, We Are the Champions, and You Light Up My Life. Changing our taste just a little, we now listen to such hits as Rock Me Amadeus, Let's Go All the Way, Manic Monday, and who could forget the bundle of Tina Turner hits, including What's Love Got to Do with It. As kids, we watched movies such as Star Wars, Rocky, Smokey and the Bandit, and The Bad News Bears, and then matured into such movies as Rambo, A Nightmare on Elm Street, Poltergeist 2, and lest we forget, Pee-wee's Big Adventure. We've done a lot of things during our lives, many of which we will not forget. We've learned a lot here at Fridley, but now it is time to move on. Today marks the end of an era for us. Our high school days are over, and we must take a leap up to the real world. Tonight is our last night to share together as high schoolers. This is a night you will never forget. It is a time to laugh, a time to cry, and a time for a big sigh of relief. Tonight is the last night you will see some of your classmates. It is a night for goodbyes and congratulations. Tonight, I would like to see everybody hugging everyone. Talk to people you seldom talk to because it may be your last chance. After tonight, who knows where everyone will go. Some of us will go on to college, some will go to work, some will go into the armed forces, some will get married, and some will just take a year off. No matter what you do, you'll hold some memories from this school. You'll think back to when you had good times and good friends. We will all remember what high school meant to us. Tonight, let your feelings go. Celebrate and have fun, for we have finally made it. A high school career is at an end. Let's celebrate tonight as a class with class. I'd like to wish the class of 1986 a lot of luck and then some. In closing, I would like to sum up the past 12 years of our lives with a quote from the immortal Charles Dickens that I think is fitting. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. It was school. Thank you.
Thank you, Brian, for those delightful remarks. I think I'm going to ask Mr. Myers to change the order in the future so that I speak before the student, because this is getting to be an awfully tough act to follow. It's my privilege this evening to perform two tasks. First, to introduce the school board to you, and then to make a few remarks to the graduating seniors, the class of 1986. First, your school board, and if they would please stand and remain standing until I have introduced all of them, and then after I've introduced them all, I would ask you to join me in recognizing them. Mr. James Ferguson, chairperson of the board. Mr. Gordon Sangster, vice chairperson. Mr. Kurt Schrupp, director. Dr. Joe Lipinski, treasurer. Mr. Dwayne Prairie, clerk. And Ms. Judy Zerbe, director, who is unable to be with us tonight. Please join me in thanking these people for their efforts on behalf of the Fridley Schools. Now to the class of 1986, the graduating seniors. First of all, my sincere congratulations to each one of you, and best wishes to each one of you individually in whatever course you pursue from this point. Whether it be college, or employment, or the military, or otherwise, I'm confident that you have the tools to do well, and I'm also confident that you have been very well prepared. Good luck to each one of you. I could stop there, I suppose, but I'm not going to this evening, as you've learned over 13 years that Brian has summed up in 15 minutes, and I can't understand how he did that. But as you've learned over 13 years, we educators always have some advice, and I can't resist the temptation tonight to use this one last opportunity to give you some of that. I know you've received a lot of that lately from a lot of people, including those people sitting here around you this evening, but I have one last piece of advice that may be just a little bit different, and then I have some advice from your moms, from your dads, from your loved ones, from your friends, from your relatives who are here tonight to support you and show you that they love you. That advice is something that I've gathered by talking to them over the past couple of years. And it's advice that I think if you will follow carefully, wherever it is that you go, or whoever it is that you become, or whatever it is that you do, if you follow their advice carefully, I assure you of a very rich and a very full life. First of all then, My advice to you people is really very simple. My advice to you is that whatever you do in your life, be sure that you take some risks. Whatever you do in your life, be sure that you take some risks. Now, I want to caution you, there's a possible downside to this risk-taking business. There are some possible pitfalls to this risk-taking business. Again, Brian pointed out some of them. For example, when you laugh, you risk appearing the fool. When you weep, you risk appearing sentimental to others. When you reach out for another, you risk involvement. When you expose your feelings, you risk exposing your true self. When you place your ideas or your dreams or your visions before the crowd or before the group or before your friends, you risk their ridicule, and in fact, you even risk their loss. When you love somebody else, You risk not being loved in return. When you hope, you risk despair. When you try, you'll be risking failure. Indeed, to live is to risk dying. But I'm suggesting to you tonight that you take all of these risks and more, and that you do so over and over and over again and again throughout your life, because the greatest hazard that faces you, the greatest hazard that faces you as you move ahead, is to risk nothing. If you choose to risk nothing, then you do nothing, you have nothing, and you are nothing. And that simply cannot happen to any single one of you sitting out here tonight. I want you to consider some risk takers with me for just a moment, and consider how they have made the world a richer place for all of us, a richer place for you, a richer place for me, and a richer place for the world in general. For example, if a young boy who was labeled too stupid to learn, hadn't taken some risks, we never would have had a Thomas Edison. If an 80-year-old lady who was told she was too old to start painting hadn't taken some risks, we never would have had a Grandma Moses. If a young boy who was called dull and hopeless and indeed was flunked in the sixth grade hadn't taken some risks, and some really big risks, we'd have never had Winston Churchill. If a boy who loved to sketch and draw but was told that he had no talent at all and should stop hadn't taken some risks, we never would have had a Walt Disney. If a young girl who was denied at birth the ability to see, the ability to hear, and the ability to speak hadn't taken some risks, hadn't reached out to others, we never would have had a Helen Keller. And tonight, if Brian Bissonette hadn't agreed to take some risks, we wouldn't have had the chance to hear his delightful remarks this evening. These people were all risk takers, and they were risk takers who really lived. They really lived. Now, it's true, you can probably avoid a lot of sorrow and a lot of suffering if you don't take any risks at all. But you can't really learn, you can't really grow, you can't really love, you can't really change, and you can't really live unless you risk. And my advice to you tonight then is really very simple. My advice to you is to really live, and to take some risks to assure that richness and fullness in your life. Now, finally, from your parents, from your moms, your dads, from your loved ones, from your relatives, and from your friends who are sitting here tonight, they have some advice for you too. And they want you to listen carefully to it, because they think it'll be important to you and have a lot to do with how rich and full your life becomes wherever you're going. And they have just 5 short statements that they'd like you to listen to. First of all, and the first one is very closely related to what I've just said, their first piece of advice to you is, it's far better to try and fail than never to try at all. Try your best for the best, and if you don't make it, it's okay to fail. Their second piece of advice for you is, don't lie and cheat. Be honest. You can lose almost everything in your life, but nobody can ever take honesty from you. Their third piece of advice is, don't forget common sense. You'll almost always be able to feel or sense right from wrong. If it feels wrong, don't do it. Their fourth piece of advice, which Brian reminded us of again tonight, is there is humor in almost everything you will ever do, and in almost every place you will ever be. Look for it and don't lose it. And finally, their last piece of advice to you is, it's okay to like people. As you go along through life in whatever direction you choose, and you're choosing a lot of different directions, I've looked at the materials. If you remember those 5 things from those who love you the most, you really can't go wrong. Congratulations to each one of you. Good luck to each one of you. You have the possibility of an incredibly marvelous and exciting future. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Renz. I would like to extend my congratulations to the class of 1986. And I've already told them earlier this evening how I felt about them as a class. And I want you parents and grandparents and friends who are here to understand that we have thoroughly enjoyed the class of 1986. And they have set some marks for other classes to follow that we are very proud of. With the assistance of Dr. Ingvaldson, at this time I would like to present the members of the class of 1986 to the Board of Education. Class, will you please stand? Dr. Ingvaldson? Members of the Board of Education and Superintendent Renz, the members of this class have fulfilled all of the requirements for graduation from this school, as set forth by the State Board of Education and the Board of Education of Independent School District 14. In recognition of this achievement, they are entitled to their diplomas as graduates of Fridley High School. We seek the cooperation of all guests this evening in withholding your applause and cheers until the entire class has been presented. Chairman Ferguson, at this time, Dr. Ingvaldson and I will call the class of 1986 to the platform to receive their diplomas. Asina Abraham. Grant Ackerman. Melissa Albay. Julie Allen, Connie Anderson, Jody Anderson, Mark Anderson, Michelle Anderson, Paul Anderson, Randall Anderson, Mary Annette, Thomas Archer, John Auger, Mary Jo Boney, Deborah Becker, Brian Balcom, Aurora Benefield, Scott Berg, Daniel Berganini, Don Bergquist, Brian Bissonette, Thomas Bloom, Michael Bolison, Lori Bonesteel, Michelle Bonner, Todd Boone, Dennis Borgen, Deanna Bozer, Aaron Bowman, Daryl Breitenfeld, John Brickner, Robert Bridgman, Elliot Briggs, John Bruno, Shara Beekler, Kelly Buxa, Kimberly Butkaisayam, David Bezeski, Mary Campbell, Diane Carlson, Christopher Karen, Dane Carson, Daniel Chido, Kristen Clark, Catherine Cody, Rodney Cook, Janine Corbett, Gary Danielson, Christine Davis, Jonathan Dean, Lachelle DeBoer, Todd Dolan, Laura Doucette, Jan Ebert, Charles Ellis, John Elwell, Diane Engdahl, James Engstrom, Douglas Epsky, Greg Erickson, Dutch Erkenbrack, Deborah Fenske, Maria Fernandez, John Fisher, Lawrence Flott, John Flegel, John Flora, William Frawley, Jeffrey Frederick, Timothy Gannon, Sherry Gemlow, Jonathan Gervais, Angela Goodpaster, Donna Grimes, Sandy Guzik, Byung Ho Han, John Hansen, Glenn Hansen, Victoria Harris, Kari Harstead, Lisa Hartsey, David Harvett, David Hastings, Jackie Haugen, Andy Heimstead, Jesper Henriksen, Julie Henriksen, David Henches, Susan Hesselton, Anita Hillbrand, Mark Holland. Kelly Holmberg. Dennis Hoppy. Kurt Hobson. Lisa Hobson. Lori Houle. Samantha Iaquinto. Molly Johns. Jeffrey Johnson. Kim Johnson. Robert Johnson. Stacy Johnson. Lori Johnstone. Lynn Johnstone. Tiffany Julian. Jeff Kallstorff. Kristen Castleknack. Patrick Kaufman. Patrick Kelly. Robert Kersey. Sarah Kahn. Ann King. Kristen Kesey. Susan Kishish. Sean Klinsing. Joel Knight. Paul Cook. Tracy Krumpetich. Jeffrey Kubatowitz. Timothy Kudabe. Okay. Peter Keekley. Kari Kunze. Jennifer Cush. Cynthia LaBelle. Rosemary Lambert. Scott Langer. Deborah Larson. Dwayne Larson. Shale Laubach. Nancy Leon. Jennifer Lee. Chad Lennox. Jennifer Lewis. Laura Lindquist. Joseph Lund. Hao Lee. Kink Lee. Jeffrey Link. Kelly Lynn. Timothy Marchafava. Cindy Marsolik. Shelley Martinson. Thomas Masuda, Shauna McHugh, Tim McDonald, Michael McDonough, Michelle McGraw, Troy McClellan, Krista McMillan, Catherine Messenger, Terry Matoxin, Julie Meyerendorf, Audra Mickelson, Angela Miller, Christine Miller, Beth Milston, Michael Miskowick, Lynn Moldenauer, Dana Molinari, David Munson, Amy Moore, Jeffrey Moore, Tracy Morix, Rochelle Morrow, Robert Mulhern, Craig Munson, Marguerite Myers, Michael Nash, Connie Nelson, Lisa Nelson, Deanna Nevela, Catherine Nielsen, Daniel Nisnik, Michelle Nolby, Amy Nyberg, Terry Nygaard, Richard Olson, Brian Olson, John Olson, Lori Olson, Sonia Olson, Dean Osborne, Michael Oswald, Sherry Overby, Carolyn Pappas, Tracy Paddock, Todd Penke, Christine Purcell, Kirsten Peterson, Sheila Peterson, Francisca Picar, Kathleen Pitts, Dennis Plaque, Joseph Plessel, Norman Palmerlew. Lisa Pizek. Jody Renapenning. David Ryder. Jean Robbins. Paul Robertson. Laura Ron. Patrick Ross. Eric Rao. Mansoor Sajedi. Anthony Schaff. Patrice Shearer. Dion Schilling. Dolores Schleter. John Schwartz. Michelle Scott. James Scoville. William Severson. Michael Sherry. Michael Siegfried. Kimberly Silseth. Leslie Simino. David Sinner. Kirk Shervold. Christine Smith. Leslie Smith. William Snee. Chris Soderstrom. Elizabeth Summers. Carl Static. Trent Steckman. Pamela Steffen. Robert Stockman. Charles Storvik. Frank Sud. Richard Svenningson. Jackie Tank. It'll stay. Jody Taylor. Patrick Taylor. Tim Taylor. Carrie Ann Terrell. Bruce Thomas. James Tickey. Kelly Tilseth. Eric Tollickson. Todd Trochick. Stephen Troll. Jeffrey Tolbain. Paula Toombs. Thomas Toombs. Brad Vaki. James Van Erden. Trent Van Halsen. Selena Van Kempen. Joseph Vance. Fu Vu. Jacqueline Wattenhofer. Timothy Weiss. Nick Wickern. Dean Wiley. Natalie Williams. Patrick Wisniewski. Gregory Watowitz. Terry Reith. Ellen Yee. Denise Zafke. John Zake. Cynthia Zwicky. Mr. Ferguson, Dr. Renz, Board of Education, the class of 1986. Please join me.
Will you rise, please? And receive the benediction. May God Almighty send you his light and truth to keep you all the days of your lives. May the hand of God protect you. May his holy angels accompany you. May God the Father and God the Son and God the Holy Spirit cause his grace to be mighty upon you. Amen.